The third Deputy Prime Minister, Rukia Esanga Nakadama, today presented to Parliament a statement on the alleged bloated delegation of 71 government officials to the 78th session of the United Nations General Assembly, which took place in September this year in New York. She noted that the wide and ever-growing scope of the agenda, the main work at the General Assembly, is simultaneously conducted through six functional committees, which require specialists who understand the specific body.
And the fact that Uganda is scheduled to host the summits of the non-aligned movement, that is NAM, and the group of 77 plus China in January 2024, the delegation participated in a number of bilateral meetings on the margins of the assembly. The membership of the G77 plus China reaffirmed the decision to host the 30th summit in Kampala in January 2024.
Nakadama refuted the figure of 71 delegates, saying only 31 delegates were funded by the government of Uganda, while 17 delegates were funded by the UN and partners. She adds that the alleged 21 delegates did not travel to the New York for the UN General Assembly this year, as reported.
Indeed, 10 of these are diplomatic staff at our permanent mission in New York.
Nakadama also revealed that Uganda's delegation to the UN General Assembly contains spouses of some cabinet ministers, whom she said were cleared to travel by the president.
The multiple complex issues on the agenda, as well as the multiple meetings that were held simultaneously relative to the size of the Uganda's delegation, where some MDAs were not represented, many issues of great importance to the country we are not attended to.
The third Deputy Prime Minister also apologized on behalf of the government for bickering that erupted among cabinet members arising from this controversial trip to New York.
But on behalf of government, we say next time we shall do better. I thank you.
Please try to narrow it outside the public, because some of these things came out because of the utterances that were coming out, one versus the other.
The report did not face a tough scrutiny on the floor of parliament, since opposition had walked out of the chambers by the time Nakadama took to the floor.
Media should be informed that before a story goes out, research. But I don't see research taking place in many of the stories that come about, and the effects of that are what you've seen over time.
Such a rate has got to the media. How is government operating? Because the media didn't go on, I'm sure the media, I even saw the letter, okay? So such a letters going out, if they are meant for certain officers, how does government control their documents? You'll find it's people within government themselves who are giving this to the media.
But the Deputy Speaker, Thomas Taiyebu, advised the government to step up its communication strategies in order to address such embarrassing scandals on time before causing big damage.
Because I think what we are dealing with was just a PR issue, a public relations issue, even beyond anything else. So I think government, next time you need to handle these matters better.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.